with the help of the regional HIV/AIDS connection, we interviewed 127 people who inject drugs. And of those, some had HIV and many did not. And we asked them how they inject and what they do. And what was very interesting is that asking the question, do you share cookers and filters, the equipment used to inject the drug, was extremely common, particularly if people used hydromorph cotton. In fact, 96% of people who used hydromorph cotton reused and did multiple washes with the drug. So sharing the equipment alone, even without sharing any needles or syringes, was associated with 22 times more likely being HIV positive.
The equipment that is used by injection drug users typically is very sterile, and it's not typically reused, especially needles. The difficulty is that when the drug preparation changed from OxyContin to hydromorph cotton, this material that was used, these drugs that were used in many individuals in London, had different properties. And those properties of those drugs helped the virus to live on the drug injection equipment. Through our laboratory, we really could prove that the virus remained stable, and that unfortunately, if there was any sharing of these materials, it could lead to this outbreak that we observed.
Nobody wants to be using their equipment in a way that puts them at risk. People want to be doing things that are as safe as possible. So understanding that if you heat your cooker to boiling for 10 seconds, that can make a huge difference in your risk of getting an infection was so important for us to understand. And then the people that essentially taught us are also the people that can teach other people. So getting that message out to frontline workers, getting that message out to healthcare providers, and especially getting that message out to the patients themselves.